Welcome back once again, Cor Unum Cohort. That's also difficult to say. Dr. Mike Brummond here, still marching us through some questions, some philosophical questions about our ideas. Now we're going to move on to another question about ideas. This question is, do common abstractions refer to any reality apart from concrete individuals? Everybody got that? Okay, so again, remember when we talked about ideas, right? We have ideas of specific things. That cat, that house, the color blue I'm seeing right now. But we also have what we're calling here common abstractions. Just the idea of cat, or the idea of house, or the idea of the color blue, without giving specific instances. All right, so this question asks, do those common abstractions, which are sometimes called universals, do they actually exist? Like, is there anything out there that is just blueness, or catness, or houseness? We know, well, we think we know, and I'm pretty sure I know, that there are things out there like cats that I have ideas about, individual cats and houses and blue things. But what about when I just talk about the idea of cat in general? Is that a thing, right? So that's what we're asking about. Do these common abstractions refer to any reality apart from the actual concrete individuals? That is, does cat in general name any reality apart from the set or collection of all individual cats, right? Is there just a whole bunch of individual cats? Or is there also this added thing called catness, right? Or the essence of a cat, or the universal idea of a cat? Now, I know this is the kind of thing that keeps you up at night wondering, but follow along with me here. One school will say no. The idea of cat or catness does not refer to any real thing. This is called nominalism. Nominalism says no. These are just general terms. General terms such as cat, human being, dog, tree, desk. They're just a shorthand way of talking about respective sets of cats, humans, dogs. They're just names. That's where we get the name nominalism. It means name. Right? They're just kind of shorthand. So instead of saying that cat and that cat and that cat and that cat, I just can use the word cat as shorthand for the entire set. Well, this has the advantage, it seems really simple in that sense. It has the advantage that the only real things that exist out there in the world are individual, concrete, particular things. So proponents of this view believe that we ought not to postulate any weird realities that aren't concrete, individual things. There's some common sense to that. I can go to the pet store and buy a cat, but I can't go to the pet store and buy cat or catness. Not catnip, you can buy that, but catness. But then there's another group, realism or realists. Right, with regards to these abstract general terms called universals, they say yes. Yes, general terms such as cat do name realities, which are in various ways distinct from simply the collection of all cats. So this says yes, in addition to that cat and that cat and that cat and every other individual cat, there is such a thing as catness. It exists somehow. Now there's various views regarding what this reality over and above all actual individual cats is. Most philosophers who are realists with regards to general terms would accept it in one of a few different ways. So for instance, we'll call this A. Maybe cats name kind of a shared reality. A shared reality, that is a kind of reality that can exist in many places at once. Unlike individual cats, right? So individual cats can only exist right there or over there, but This would be some kind of shared reality that can be in many places at once. This shared reality is simply the essence or nature of being a cat, right? I mean, there's something in cat A, B, and C that makes them all cats. And so this would be that shared reality. Right? There's this shared reality is the essence or nature of being a cat, which exists in many places, right? In all cats. All at the same time. This shared reality is just the set of all the essential properties that make cats cats. Okay. How about another option? We'll call this B. Cat, in this idea, catness, names a concept that exists in the minds of intelligent beings who know what a cat is. That is, who know the above mentioned essence or nature of cat. So, yeah, maybe it really does, catness does exist, but instead of existing in cats, it really exists in your mind. Oh, okay. Well, but what if there were no people? Would catness still exist? Well, we could call this C. Instead, maybe cats name an eternally possible mode of existence, right? Maybe it doesn't have to exist in our mind, but it's just simply a possible mode of existence. So cat would exist in this sense, even if there were no cats. Just as unicorn, right? The idea of unicornness exists, even though there are no actual existing unicorns. Another one might be, we'll call D, catness. Precisely because it exists as this eternally possible mode of existence, exists in the mind of God as an eternal idea. So maybe these universal ideas, maybe they do have existence, but they exist in God's mind from all eternity. But then there is what's called Plato. If you know a little bit of philosophical background, you'll often hear about Plato's forms. Plato believed that catness actually existed. So we'll call this E. Cat names an eternal idea or ideal, or we'll call it a form that exists even outside of God's mind. Now I've got another video for you to watch in the playlist here that talks a little bit more about these universals and their problems. This all seems abstract, I know, but we're going to see when we get to class that this has some pretty major repercussions in the way we talk about theology and the way we understand the world. So stay tuned for that.